News Review from BBC Learning English.
Hello and welcome to News Review, the programme where we give you the language from the latest news stories and tell you how to use it in your everyday English. Hi, I'm Neil. Joining me is Dan.
Hello, everybody.
And what story have you got for us today, Dan?
Today's story is about a fast food feast.
Fast food feast. Lots of there.
You'll see more of it.
Let's hear some more from this BBC World Service news report.
President Trump has bought hamburgers and pizzas for a college football team visiting the White House, blaming the government shutdown for the takeaway menu. The White House is operating with a smaller staff owing to the federal government partial shutdown.
So, the Clemson Tigers are the college football champions currently, and they were invited to eat at the White House to celebrate. However, the timing is awful. Unfortunately, the federal government has suffered a shutdown over budgeting disagreements, and this means that public sector workers are or have been on leave for 24 days. However, President Trump didn't want to cancel the visit, and so he paid for over 300 hamburgers, as well as pizzas and chips, or French fries if you prefer, with his own money so that they could celebrate together.
Yeah, okay. Doesn't sound like a particularly healthy diet for a sports team, but anyway, you've been looking into this story and you've chosen three words. What have you got?
We've got smorgasbord, bites, and can't stomach it.
Smorgasbord, bites, and can't stomach it. So that first word, Dan, smorgasbord.
All right. It comes from the Boston 25 News and says, Trump serves fast food smorgasbord to Clemson Tigers during White House celebration.
Smorgasbord, a selection of food served so people can help themselves. Now, forgive me if I'm wrong, Dan, but that word smorgasbord, that's not English, is it?
No, it's certainly not.
Why are we talking about a word that's not English in this English program?
Well, it's an extremely useful Swedish loanword.
A loanword.
That's correct. It's a word that we've borrowed from another language because it serves a particular purpose. Smorgasbord is a noun, and it's basically, in layman's terms, it's a buffet. So it's a selection of usually cold, but it can incorporate hot food that's laid out that everybody can just help themselves. And it can be mixed in all sorts of bits and pieces like that.
A selection of food, like a buffet, which
That's
is
right.
a French word.
French loan word. We're using a French loan word to describe a Swedish loan word, but never mind.
But it has the same meaning. It means something else as well, though, doesn't
That's
it?
That's right. So smorgasbord now has been sort of used in a different sense to mean a collection of things to choose from. In the same way that you have a selection of food that you can help yourself to, smorgasbord now can mean a collection of things to choose from.
A wide variety.
That's the one. So, for example, Neil, if you were to come over to my house this weekend, I would offer you a smorgasbord of entertainment. There would be movies, there would be cards, there would be drinks, we could go listen to music, we could go dancing, we could go in the garden, play football, whatever you wanted.
I'm just waiting for that invitation.
It's never going to happen. smorgasbord is often followed by of, by the way. That's the preposition. A smorgasbord of entertainment.
Okay, so if you said you'd like to invite me around for this smorgasbord of entertainment, it doesn't mean there'd be a load of Swedish food on the table.
No, it doesn't mean necessarily that there would be Swedish food on the table. We're using it metaphorically. Although, should you wish for Swedish food, I can also provide you.
That could also be there.
No problem.
Okay.
Another good example would be that the human body, in order to stay healthy, requires a smorgasbord of physical activities. It's not just running, not just swimming, but lots and lots of different things to be at its peak physical fitness.
Okay, let's look at our next headline.
Our next headline comes from the Straits Times and says, as shutdown bites, Trump foots bill for fast food feast.
Bites has an unpleasant effect.
That's right, and you'll notice that fast food feast there again.
Yes, indeed.
I do love alliteration.
This is a clever headline, of course, because it's about food and eating, and they've used the word bites, so again, it's a pun, which we see all the time.
That's right.
Obviously, I'm confused.
And why is that?
Because I thought bites meant...
Exactly. Well, that is exactly what it means. It means to sink your teeth into something or unfortunately, someone, which is kind of relevant. Have you ever been bitten, Neil?
Oh, yeah, my children used to bite me all the time.
Goodness, I hope they've stopped doing that now.
Yeah, they have.
Yeah, good. Okay, well, so how does it feel to be bitten?
Well, it hurts. It's not very nice.
No, and that is the related meaning of this word. If something bites, it takes hold and affects something in an unpleasant way, much like being bitten.
Yeah.
So in our headline here, as shutdown bites refers to the federal shutdown, which has been going on for approximately 24 days now, and that means that the effects, the unpleasant effects of that, are now beginning to manifest. They're beginning to take hold.
We can also use this to talk about
recessions. Recessions can bite in the same way that the shutdown can bite.
Yeah.
We could talk about hunger, which is very strange, really, when you think about it,
yes.
Because biting is the thing that you do to the food to stop hunger, but we can say hunger bites.
Yeah.
When hunger bites, get some food. And of course, if you're a very, very pessimistic person, you might say, man, reality bites.
Absolutely. Okay, let's move on now to our final headline.
Our final headline comes from Time magazine and says, President Trump feeds college football national champions fast food and Twitter can't stomach it.
Can't stomach it. Unable to accept it.
That's right. Now, food, Neil, where does it get into your body?
Well, you eat it. It goes in your mouth.
That's right.
Down your esophagus.
Ooh, esophagus. Very nice.
To your stomach.
That's correct, where it is digested. Now, what happens if the food is not good?
Well, it either comes up again pretty quickly
yes.
or goes out the other way.
Okay, well, let's leave the other way for the moment. It comes back up again
yeah.
very, very quickly.
Mm.
And how does it feel when it comes back up? Is it good?
Disgusting.
Yes, it's not a pleasant feeling at all. So if you can't stomach something, it means that you are unable to handle or take hold of a particular idea or a particular situation.
Mm.
For example, action movies. I like action movies.
Okay.
I like violent movies, guys fighting, things like that. But sometimes, once in a while, I will see something in a movie that is too violent, too much blood, and I can't stomach it. I'll have to leave the movie because I'm unable to bear that situation
yeah.
any longer.
Have you ever been to a really... a party where people aren't really getting on with each other.
Oh, it's so awkward, isn't it? Oh, yeah. No, it's horrible. It's absolutely awkward. What would you do?
I wouldn't be able to stomach that. I would just leave.
That's it. That's another good example. Or physical training. Let's say that you're a recruit going into the army and you have to do, I don't know, 12 weeks of intense physical, you know, lots of push-ups and pull-ups, and you decide, you know, I just can't stomach this. And so you leave. You quit.
Yeah.
So basically, any situation or idea that you're uncomfortable with,
yeah.
you're not able to adapt to or take in, you can't stomach it.
Or figuratively speaking, you're not able to digest it.
That's the one.
Yeah. And of course, again, another clever headline. It's about food and it's got the word stomach.
That's right.
A recap of that vocabulary, please, Dan.
So we had smorgasbord, a selection of food served so people can help themselves. Bites, has an unpleasant effect, and can't stomach it, be unable to accept something.
If you would like to test yourself on that vocabulary, there is a quiz you can take on our website, bbclearningenglish.com, where you can find all kinds of other activities to help you improve your English. And of course, we have an app.
That's right. It's free to download and free to use. You can get all of our content as quick as we post it.
Thanks for joining us, and goodbye.
Goodbye.
News review from BBC Learning English.